I'm sorry, I didn't notice you there. I wasn't expecting guests at all. Well, my name is Curtis Parker, and welcome to my humble abode. Now many of you may not know me as Curtis Parker. Most of you may know me in other names such as Burger Tips, Batman, or the East Side Strangler, or Tokyo, the one-eyed fish who just couldn't get it all. Many of you may think you know me, but the real question is, how well do you know me? And do you really know who I, Curtis Parker, am? In this next segment, we're going to be learning exactly just what kind of a wonderful and colorful person me.
This is Chucky.
Hope y'all enjoyed that. What do you say we go outside and check out what else is in store for y'all? Come on, let's go. Disturbia. Ugh. Anyway, just, what do you say we roll on to see what's next?
Like most people, I have a mother, father, and two sisters, and titties. But now, what do you say we meet some of the sisters?
Hey, Car, I got a surprise for you.
Get out!
Okay, so that's Carly. Allie's dead.
I'm sorry to hear that.
What are your thoughts on Curtis Parker?
Well, I don't know anybody by the name of Curtis Parker, but I do know a Batman, however, who fits that same description, so maybe it's the same guy.
What would you say some of Curtis's positive features are?
He's devilishly handsome, I'll give him that. Quite an erotic physique, I do say so myself. The hair, kind of like Wolverine from the X-Men.
Now, what do you think's inside Curtis Parker's head? So I understand you're Curtis Parker's sister. Now what are your thoughts on that?
Curtis Parker is like the hottest person ever. I totally love him. His body is like, oh my god, and his face is like, oh my god. I just want to like put butter all over him and put him on a frying pan and cook his whole body until he's nice and greasy.
Curtis Parker? I don't know Curtis Parker, but I do know Jesus. He's basically the reason that I'm alive today. When he found me, I was half dead in an alley, passed out, high out of my mind on cocaine. He set me on the path to righteousness. And wow, the things that I've accomplished, they've all been based on the acts and ideas of the legend. I guess you could call him Curtis Parker, but to me,
And what do you think of him? Now, Bryce, how has Curtis Parker influenced your life?
That's a really big question. You want, like, the full version, or do you want me to shorten the list? Because the list goes on. Well, so you want me to shorten it, alright. Well, I was basically alone in life before I met Curtis Parker. No one wanted to be around me. I smelled horrible. I had bad breath. No one liked me. I just didn't dress right, I guess. And he got me a girlfriend, Dave, hot European now, and he got me a bunch of friends.
Now, Bryce, what do you think's going on in Curtis Parker's head?
Honestly, I think that's too deep of a question for a puny mind like mine. But if I had my best guess, I was probably thinking of a new shuttle for NASA so that they can, like, free all the monkeys on the moon or something. But he was telling me something about that. But, I don't know, I heard he was doing the Queen's job for her. I'm not really sure what she does, but he said it was like he pretends he's a terrorist and then he's not actually a terrorist and stuff. And he saved lives and stuff, and it's really amazing. So I'm glad I got someone like him that I can always look up to and respect like that and get me through the days, those long, lonely days.
Now seriously, Bryce, Curtis Parker isn't that great.
Who said that? Let me tell you something. If Curtis Parker wasn't that great, would I have gotten this tattoo? Yeah, it's a big deal. And it's real.
Well, I hope you, the audience, have learned a great understanding of me, Curtis Parker. I'm very sorry, but it is time for y'all to dash, or it is didgeridoo lesson time.
And so Bryce, on to the next question.
Excuse me! Curtis Parker is not that cute.
If Curtis Parker wasn't that amazing, damn it, would I have gotten this?